Hi, update about the Canon Yon still video camera. As expected, I found that the original battery is completely dead. By the way, it is a lead acid battery. So it is not possible at all to find a replacement battery. However, you can maybe find aftermarket adapters allowing to insert a 9-volt battery in some kind of holder replacing this battery and then use a 9-volt battery as a power source. The user manual for the camera says you can take up to 600 photos with a full battery because yes, you have no color TFT display, so it must not be a very big electricity dump, this thing, when running. This is quite efficient. So, as I could not find a replacement battery, I did one from wood. So, the goal here is just to get access to the contacts, which are deep inside, into a reliable way, in order to be able to power on the camera. So, it was a little bit of work, but it is working well. I use these bits of flat flex in order to drive the contacts outside with the camera lid closed, because there is a interlock. You cannot power on the camera if this cover is not in place. And yes, surely enough, the camera is working. So I found one cat picture on the card, but I accidentally deleted it. And there was not any other picture, the card was blank. But at least the floppy disk. But at least if I find other floppy disks like this, I will be able to read them. So, as you can see, it is saying low battery. So I had an issue, in fact, with this not making terribly good contact. And it was quite a bit hard to figure out. Okay, now it is working, so it is not perfect. It is a quick and dirty thing I didn't make, so it can be improved. So it says I have 50 shots remaining, maybe. Here I am on the number one. I still have a low battery alert, but I am supplying it with almost 10 volts. It is quite weird. So, in fact, in this setup, I should be able to read the content of the photo. There is a test photo I did. So, I had to modify this jack, 2.5 millimeter jack, in order to be able to plug it, because with a rubber rod here, it was not... plastic around, and then it was not fitting correctly, but now it is good. So I have my little tele monitor here. Well, blanking monitor. I use usually for making videos. And yes, here is the test photo I did take. And as you can see, we have a picture. If I change, in fact, on the camera here, the number of the picture, it seems that as the other ones are blank, it will not change the picture here. So now I will try to make a photo of my power supply, for instance. So you can find all the regular settings you get on cameras. On these things, there is a red flap in the viewfinder that gets in place when you are in macro mode. I will set V. It is quite weird. In fact, it says it is the card is the disk is full, but no, it is not full, and no, it will not take a photo. And it says low battery. It is quite a pain, this thing to use. Honestly, maybe my fake battery is not making correct contact. So let me reset it. No, it seems ready to take photos. So I wonder if there is some kind of problem with with a floppy disk. And again, it says low battery. Ah, it was working perfectly yesterday, of course, and today it is not working correctly anymore. Because I want to make a video about it. Obviously, we have power. It is seeking the scanning the disk here, and my picture is here again. Okay, so if I go now into picture taking mode, it is saying I am full. So let me try to erase everything. You must click all erase, erase, and execute. And surely enough, now I have a black screen. I did already check the floppy disk is not write protected, so it is not the issue. It still will not take a photo. I was able to take a photo yesterday, and now it is not doing it anymore. So is the video floppy disk worn out or something like this? I have no clue. Oh no, it seems ready. It is the track number one. So I can set save timer mode. I will aim at my it seems you cannot view the picture on the screen before you shoot it. So yes, it did take a photo. So if I go again in playback, here is a photo I just took. Okay, so it is a little bit wonky, this thing. So it is a little bit off focus, but it is in macro mode and it seems the focusing distance of the macro mode must be very precisely set with this thing. For this reason, it looks like that it provides some kind of help on the strap. Yes. As you can see, it is the original strap. And here you have a mark. And in fact, it is your macro photo focusing distance from the strap mount to this mark. Okay. So let me try to do another photo. I will do, there is intervalometer mode, so you can do time lapse or something like this. You have single and continuous shot. So let's go in single. The flash, I have no clue how it works, seems it is not it did not trigger yet, but maybe. Oops. No clue of what did happen here. It looks like he did recopy the image onto every track of the floppy disk. Very, very weird. So let's do again the erase all. Here we are. And now again it will not record. This blinking 50 means it considers the floppy disk is full. But surely enough, it is not full. trying to figure out the thing. And again, it is doing this. Instead of making another shot, it is filling the disc. And yes, this is the last photo I did take, and every track seems to be filled with this. So not sure if it is a feature or if it is a bug, but obviously it is pretty annoying. So let me try to go back onto the wheel. Again, erase everything. And now it seems to be very slowly erasing the floppy disk. I do not think it could copy the image on all the tracks on the floppy disk so quickly, you know. Anyway, really, really weird. Oh, by the way, the picture you get on this is really old school. Analog video picture by the quality, you can tell. So we need to wait a little bit of time. The access time to the disk seems pretty decent, by the way. It is quite rare to think that it is recorded. Is an analog signal recording of a disc. Now it is doing something, but there is not a function for formatting the disc, just overwriting this, the pictures. Okay, we are on track number one, we have nothing, we have blue screen here. Seems we have no signal output. So I found the best way that works the best is the self-timer still. So let's take a photo of my camcorder up there. It is 10 seconds. Another one. Oh, my mount, for instance, like so. And again, same thing. So I do not know what is going on here. Very, very weird. Interesting. So maybe it will need a little bit of. Of my additional research, this thing, because I do not think it is working normally at this point when skipping all the tracks like so. It should just do tracks one at a time. And yes, again, it says the disc is full. Okay, quite interesting. But I am quite happy of my setup here. I found to fake the battery. It is quick and dirty, but it allows to get access easily to the battery contacts. And probably now it is reliable. Since it is inserted, it is making good contact. So I do not say it will work each time, but with a simple shape of battery like this, when you have no access to an external DC plug, or it is just a completely stupid proprietary thing, and it is not a smart battery, it is obviously something you can do. A next level should be to do a 9 volt battery adapter, but it will be a lot more of work, and I do not think it will be useful anyway, as I am not expecting to use this thing a lot. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye bye.